Flight 8's hardware recently transitioned out of the staging phase, signaling a revival in the launch schedule. Meanwhile, SpaceX has been sharing updates on the Tesla Roadster and Starman, commemorating the momentous achievement and the endless possibilities of space exploration. Furthermore, NASA has revealed the first images from the Europa Clipper as it embarks on its expedition to Jupiter, marking a remarkable achievement in the field of deep space exploration. Let's get our heads around it in today's episode of NR Studio. It's been more than 3 weeks since Flight 7, the first Starship launch of the year, and it's time to focus our attention on the upcoming mission. Preparations for these flights have been underway for a long period. E-15 underwent cryogenic testing in December, with S-3 then undergoing similar testing in mid-January, shortly after Flight 7. Following these important assessments, both stages were directed to the bay for careful inspection and final installation. Since then, progress on both phases has remained secret, creating even higher anticipation for updates among many. However, we are now witnessing progress. This was foreshadowed by the announcement of a short ramp closure schedule, which indicated a restriction from midnight to 6 a.m. on February 8th for the transport of materials from the factory to the launch pad. On cue, the B-15 was launched from Mega Bay, safely docked in a prearranged booster carrier bay. As anticipated, the journey took about 2 hours, and upon reaching its destination, it was adjusted into place on the blowpipe. This move signified significant progress toward the upcoming static fire test. The planned ramp closure for testing purposes will occur from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Central Time on February 9th, 10, and 11. This schedule provides ample opportunity for SpaceX to complete testing and transport the B-15 back to the production facility for inspection and installation. The rapid return of the launch pad to operational readiness further demonstrates SpaceX's growing efficiency. Currently, the interval between flights is about 3 weeks. Amidst the ongoing progress of SpaceX's continuous improvement efforts, prior to each launch, improvements are implemented to reduce the potential for damage to the pad, significantly reducing repair time. Following Flight 7, scaffolding was immediately erected along the orbital launch route to facilitate major repairs, as anticipated. Simultaneously, the launch tower, Megazilla Arm, quick disconnect, and communication systems underwent a thorough inspection and necessary adjustments. Refueling and water supply were systematically carried out, along with valves being installed into the storage tanks to improve the fueling infrastructure, while large fans were used to facilitate nitrogen removal. Immediately following these adjustments, SpaceX conducted a nitrogen release test in the OLM, which confirmed that all systems were operating at peak efficiency. Attention is now sharply focused on the upcoming B-15 test. There is much to look forward to. Initially, we anticipate validation of prospective improvements, particularly the unprecedented changes to the V2 iteration of the thruster. More interesting, however, is the question of engine reusability. The B-1 set the benchmark for Raptor reusability, exemplified by the Raptor 31, which underwent previous testing on the B-12. With this in mind, it makes sense that the B-15 could incorporate a reused engine from the B-12 or B-1. If SpaceX can successfully integrate the updated Raptor, it would be a substantial step forward in the company's efforts to achieve complete reusability. Concurrently, in Mega Bay 2, S-3 is in the process of installing its engines following its cryogenic testing phase. Once completed, it will be transported to Massey for its designated static fire inspection. According to the line closure schedule, this transfer could occur as early as February 10th. After test tank 16 returns to the production site on February 9th, S-3 is expected to be equipped with more significant upgrades than B-15, specifically to address challenges encountered during the previous flight. These upgrades will be critical to ensuring the success of the mission. As for the launch schedule, no official announcement has been made. However, according to the FCC license, the launch will not occur before the 2nd. Given the momentum with B-15 and the anticipated developments with S-3, a launch by the end of the month seems like a feasible goal. However, before that possibility occurs, it is important for us to first observe how B-15 performs during testing. The pressing question at hand is whether SpaceX will reuse engines from previous missions for B-15. We invite your thoughts on this matter in the comments section below. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel to stay informed about SpaceX's incredible efforts. Your help is vital as we move towards our next goal of reaching 10,000 subscribers. Together, we will continue to explore this incredible era of SpaceX and Starship as the future of spaceflight unfolds before our eyes, with the journey truly just beginning. As we eagerly await the B-15 test and future Starship development, it's wise to take a moment to acknowledge the incredible progress SpaceX has made so far. It's been 7 years since the debut of the Tesla Roadster and Starman's presence on the Falcon Heavy's maiden flight. On February 6, SpaceX marked the anniversary with an update on the X that sheds light on the illustrious payload's journey. In a tweet, SpaceX wittily addressed a prevalent misunderstanding. This is not the asteroid you seek. 7 years ago today, Starman was launched aboard the inaugural mission of Falcon Heavy, and it recently made a pass by Earth in late January. Throughout the years, numerous observations have erroneously classified Starman and the Roadster as an asteroid, resulting in considerable confusion. Although these instances of misidentification have ignited controversy, they have simultaneously sustained engagement with the mission. The primary emphasis, nonetheless, lies in the extraordinary odyssey of Starman and his vehicle. What has been their trajectory over the past 7 years? SpaceX addressed this in a subsequent tweet, noting that Starman's extensive orbit around the Sun takes it to a distance akin to that of Mars, periodically bringing it back in proximity to Earth. Starman affirms that the Roadster has traversed deep into the cosmos, achieving distances similar to those of Mars before its trajectory directed it back towards Earth. It is intriguing to contemplate that a mannequin positioned within a vehicle, initially introduced as a demonstration payload, has journeyed farther than the majority of human-engineered artifacts are likely to achieve. What initially appeared to be a mere publicity stunt has evolved into a powerful emblem of SpaceX's grander ambitions for interplanetary exploration. By achieving orbital proximity to Mars, Starman has effectively positioned itself as a harbinger of the missions that SpaceX envisions in the imminent future. SpaceX emphasized this importance in a subsequent tweet. Starman marks SpaceX's inaugural launch to an orbit at a distance equivalent to that of Mars. In the near future, Starships will routinely embark on journeys between Earth and Mars, as we endeavor to facilitate the establishment of a multiplanetary existence. The subsequent opportunity for a launch to Mars will present itself in late 2026. This journey of the SpaceX-affiliated Starman towards the expansive vision of Martian colonization epitomizes the motivating force behind the advancement of the Starship initiative. The indicated timeline is notably captivating. With 2026 swiftly approaching, it is anticipated, based on prior declarations by Elon Musk, that the inaugural uncrewed mission to Mars will commence within the next 2 years, succeeded by the initial crewed mission within a 4-year timeframe. Starman and the Roadster persist in their orbital voyage, periodically returning in proximity to Earth. It is noteworthy that their return manifests roughly every 7 years, indicating a discernible pattern that facilitates regular observations. Notwithstanding these reassessments, SpaceX presently has no intentions to recover the vehicle. Nonetheless, one might ponder whether SpaceX ought to contemplate the re-entry of Starman and the Roadster to Earth. Such an endeavor could yield critical insights regarding the effects of prolonged space exposure on artificial entities. The spacecraft has withstood years of intense radiation, extreme temperature fluctuations, and micrometeoroid impacts. Investigating these impacts could allow SpaceX to improve the spacecraft's design and durability for extended missions. If recovered, Roadster and Starman could find a place in museums, serving as important historical artifacts for those fascinated by space exploration. By juxtaposing them alongside other milestones in space exploration, the public would have the opportunity to observe firsthand the effects of deep space exposure on common materials. As Starman silently traverses the cosmos, realizing SpaceX's bold vision for the future, a groundbreaking new mission is just beginning. The Europa Clipper expedition has only just begun, but it has already sent back its initial data from the vast expanse of space. NASA recently revealed the first image the spacecraft has ever obtained, captured around December 202, nearly 2 months after launch. While it may seem simple at first glance, the image marks a major milestone for the mission. It depicts a vast abyss of space dotted with a scattering of bright stars. According to NASA's analysis, these stars are located between 150 and 300 light-years away. Of these celestial objects, the four brightest, Guiana, Algreb, Cross, and Alcheba, are members of the constellation Corvus. Although this image represents only 0.1% of the entire sky around Europa Clipper, it is crucial for navigation purposes. By correlating the identified celestial objects with a built-in star map, the spacecraft's star tracker, or star reference unit, is able to accurately determine its orientation, facilitating precise course adjustments on its journey to Europa. The importance of this capability was underscored 3 years earlier by Manasalami, an engineer specializing in guidance and control systems at NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory. The lack of a precise understanding of the spacecraft's orientation made it impossible to accurately point scientific instruments at Europa for data collection, as well as to properly align antennas for communications with Earth. This star tracking system is critical to ensuring Europa Clipper stays on course as it explores the vast reaches of interplanetary space. As we look to the future, the spacecraft is poised to approach Mars soon, where it is expected to use a gravity assist, likely sometime in March. This maneuver will optimize its trajectory, steering it back toward Earth before charting a course toward the Jupiter system. Upon arrival, Europa Clipper will begin its primary mission, exploring Europa, an icy moon that may have the conditions necessary to support life. NASA's latest update has reiterated the mission's three main goals. First, it will evaluate the thickness of Europa's icy crust and its interaction with the ocean layer beneath. Second, it will analyze the moon's composition, investigating key chemical elements that could facilitate the existence of life. Finally, it will describe Europa's geology by examining surface features that indicate historical or ongoing geological processes. These findings will be critical in determining whether Europa has the conditions necessary to support life, potentially paving the way for future exploration missions. This is just the beginning of Europa Clipper's vast and ambitious expedition. As it ventures further into the cosmos, the real thrills await, especially as it approaches the Jupiter system to begin its in-depth examination of Europa. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode.